Hey, how's it going, guys? RoboCop Phoenix here. I'm sure by now most of you guys have seen Sony's teardown video of the PS5 where they break it down and show us all the components that make up the PS5. But just in case you've been living under a rock, I'll link that video right at the end of this one. Alright, so I watched the PS5 teardown video over and over and over again like a madman, and one thing stood out to me, especially because a lot of big YouTubers that got their hands on the Series X reported that it runs a little hot, but it's really not something to be alarmed by. So all this got me thinking about the PS5's liquid metal cooling. So in this video, I'll break down what exactly liquid metal cooling is and why Sony and Microsoft didn't always use liquid metal in their previous consoles. So you may want to watch this video until the end. Trust me, it is definitely worth it. I put in quite a lot of work piecing this video together, same way I did my last video explaining why backwards compatibility was hard for PS5. So if you enjoyed this video, then please by all means be sure to smash that subscribe button if you haven't already, and as always, give this video a thumbs up, share it to your social media and whatnot, and feel free to drop me a comment below. Alright, now let's get back to the reason why you actually clicked on this video. What does liquid metal cooling for PS5 actually mean? Alright, so in a nutshell, liquid metal really is an alloy made out of metals like gallium and indium. It is in liquid form only at room temperatures, allowing it to have greater thermal conductivity compared to the usual thermal pastes, which are considered an industry standard. Now, best believe I'm gonna make a video comparing ordinary paste and liquid metal cooling, so make sure you're subscribed for that video. So in the PS5, the liquid metal sits right between the processor and the heatsink, which allows the console to remain cool during extended hours of gameplay processing. Well, just so you know, liquid metal isn't something new to the industry. What's new and surprising is that Sony went with this method of cooling considering it's very expensive and the application of liquid metal is quite difficult. So the inevitable byproduct of processors is that they generate heat, and modern CPUs and GPUs can produce a lot of heat without sacrificing stability and performance. But if temperatures around a processor get too high, it can begin to cause errors due to misfires in the transistors. That's where cooling comes in. Cooling usually works by putting a conductive material onto the chip to route that heat outside of the system. The important part of this system, or console in this case, is called the heatsink. And the PS5 has a big ass heatsink crammed up in there. But to get the most out of that routing, you want to ensure that there's a strong connection between the chip and the heatsink. That's the job of the thermal interface material, aka TIM, or TIM for short. Typically, systems use a paste-style TIM, but that really isn't good enough for the PS5. You see, the PS5 system on a chip is a small die running at very high clock rate, and this led to a very high thermal density in the silicon die, which required Sony to significantly increase the performance of the thermal conductor that sits between the SoC and the heatsink. And because of this, Sony chose to go with liquid metal cooling. PS5 utilizes liquid metal as the thermal interface material to ensure long-term, stable, and high cooling performance. So if liquid metal is obviously better than normal paste, why doesn't Sony or Microsoft use it often? Well, liquid metal is a challenging substance to work with. It's difficult to apply because it's electronically conductive, and the risk is that it could get on other parts of the system and cause them to short out or malfunction. You see, liquid metal also moves around a lot, which makes it difficult to ship to consumers. If you watch the teardown video as many times as I have, you will notice that there is some sort of boundary around the liquid metal. And also, another reason why liquid metal was never used in the past is that previous liquid metal alloys used for this application weren't very durable. This led to situations where you would have to reapply the TIM on a regular basis. But Sony has obviously solved these engineering complications. Sony has actually gone on record and say they have spent over 2 years preparing adoption of this liquid metal cooling mechanism, and various conceivable tests have been conducted during its adoption process. Now, I'm not sure if this means the PS5 will run as cold as ice, but hey, it does look like a long-lasting solution. So make sure you're subscribed for my next video where I break down normal paste and liquid metal paste. I'm basically going to be comparing the two. So yeah, this has been it, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Cheers.